Hey guys, welcome to another video. In this video here, we're going to see how we can do speed estimation with Ultralytics. We're going to use a YOLOv8 model, a pre-trained model for detecting cars, and then we're going to do speed estimation of cars driving in different videos. We're going to show you a bunch of different examples. I'm going to show you how you can set up the code and also the Ultralytics documentation. So let's just jump straight into it and see how it works. So we'll start inside our Ultralytics documentation. If we go inside this guides tab, we can find all the guides and also the real world projects that we have. You can also find them on our GitHub. But right now, let's scroll down to the real world projects. We have a lot of different tutorials in here. You can directly go in and copy paste code snippets using your own applications and projects. If you scroll a bit further down, we can now see we have this speed estimation. First of all, you can read about what is speed estimation, what can be used for, and so on. So the basic idea behind speed estimation is that we're going to use a YOLOv8 model from Ultralytics for object detection. Then we're going to apply tracking on top of that. So we're actually tracking our objects over a number of frames. So we track our objects over time. With that information, we can actually use it to calculate and estimate the speed that the cars and objects are moving with. So it can actually be an arbitrary object. It doesn't have to be cars. It can be whatever object that you have. You can also train your own custom models and use it directly in here as well. So once we have all our tracked objects in the frame, we also know like how many frames per second we get from either a video or our webcam stream. By using that information, we actually know the whole time frame. So we get our detections over time. So now we actually have all the information for calculating and estimating our speed. So we have our tracked objects over time. We also know the distance in the frame that it has traveled. Once we have that information together with knowing the number of frames per second, either from our camera, the video that we're processing could be like for a CCTV camera sitting alongside a highway, for example, then we have all the information. We can calculate the speed and at least estimate it, because right now we're just talking about a pixel distance and not like a real world absolute distance. So here we see some of the advantages of speed estimation. So efficient traffic control, accurate speed estimation aids in managing traffic flow and so on, precise autonomous navigation, and also enhanced surveillance security. So it can either be like how far are like people walking around inside a store, could also be like how fast are cars driving at a highway, which is probably like the best use case for this specific speed estimation application. So I'm going to show you a couple of examples for videos on a highway where we can see the results for the speed estimations. Real world applications, transportation, and here we can see the code snippet. You can directly take it, copy paste it into your own Python script and use it in your own applications and projects. We just need to specify our model. Could also be our own custom model that we are trained with Ultralytics. So just be aware here that the speed is an estimate. We can't really get like very accurate values because again, we can't really know the exact distance that the car has traveled in the real world only based on pixels. So that is one of the main problems with this one here. But again, we'll get estimates, we get a rough estimate and we kind of like know how our objects are moving and also how fast. So speed will be an estimate and may not be completely accurate. Additionally, the estimation can vary depending on GPU speed. Here we can see the different arguments that you can set for the speed estimation function. I'm going to show you that in just a second. And we also have our model.track for tracking our objects over a number of frames. So let's just jump straight into the code here. I've copy pasted a code snippet from the Ultralytics documentation directly in here in an empty Python script from scratch. So again, we're just creating an instance of our YOLO model. Right now, we're just going to go with the media model. You need to specify the video path here, or if you want to use your webcam, you can also do that. Again, then we're just going to set everything up. We are going to have a video writer so we can see the results later on. The only modification that I've done to the code from the Ultralytics documentation is that we're going to have some line points, and I'm just going to have a horizontal line in the middle of the image. And it's basically just to determine when do we want to actually calculate the speed of our tracked objects once it's crossing that line. Then we're going to set up our speed estimator. We can set the different arguments that I talked about. So we have our points, we have the names, and we also want to specify that we want to view the image while it's doing inference. We have a while loop here, just reading in frames from a video or from a webcam. We track the objects here over a number of frames. We're going to estimate the speed with our tracks and also with our image. And that's pretty much it. This is how we can do speed estimation with Ultralytics. So let's now just go over a couple of examples. I have some video files over here to the left that we can go through. So this is the first example that we're going to run through. It's more like a close-off traffic view. Then we're also going to have another video here, which is basically like a view further away. We probably want to be able to detect every single car here in the image, but we're going to get way more detections out here. Then we're going to have the line and try to see how the speed is on the highway. So yeah, let's just copy path here and let's go in and run it. So I'm going to copy the relative path, paste it in up here. It is the only thing that you have to do. And then you can run it on your own video streams as well, use it in your own applications and projects. Let's now run the program here and see the results for our speed estimation. So this is the close-up video of these cars driving. Now they have to cross this line before we're going to do the speed calculations. We see that the cars are driving around 30 kilometers per hour, both going out and in of the image. So this is probably pretty accurate. Again, sometimes we get some mispredictions. Here we have 56 kilometers per hour, so it's not like very exact all the time, but most of them is actually like around 30 kilometers per hour, which makes sense in this traffic scenario. So this is actually like a pretty nice example. Let's go in and grab the other one. So that will be this video here. Just copy the relative path. Just swap it out, everything that you have to do. And we can now run our program again and see the results. So this is a bit more further away view. Let's see how it performs. So we're going to miss a lot of detections, but if we're actually like able to track the cars and they're crossing this line, we're going to estimate the speed. On average here, when I'm just taking a look at it, it is around like 90 to 100 kilometers per hour. Right now it's going like relatively fast because I have a GPU just processing every single frame, but it's also going to store a video in your directory, so we can go in and take a look at that afterwards. But it looks pretty good here on the highway, around 90 kilometers per hour. It's a bit dense traffic, so let's go in and take a look at the video. We have speed estimation AVI file explorer. Let's now open it up and take a look at it. So the cars here is actually like moving pretty fast in the video as well, so it was not really just my GPU. Let's take a look at it here. 97, 120 kilometers, 80 kilometers here, so that could actually like be pretty close to the ground truth. We can see we have a traffic sign here saying 100 kilometers per hour, so this is like the maximum speed limit. So this could actually like be pretty close. Like, we have some guys here driving like 98 kilometers per hour. Here we can see that we have some examples with 55 and also 63 here, but this is more like a runway to the highway before they're going to merge down here further on. Here we see we have a traffic sign saying 80. Let's just take a look at that. So it's actually going in the opposite direction, but we can see here once the cars start out, they have like a value of 80. And also over here, they're driving 64 to 70 kilometers per hour. So that's pretty much it for this video here. Definitely try it out on your own computer. You can just take the code snippet from the Ultralytics documentation, test it out on your own videos. If you have any suggestions to how this system here could be improved, definitely throw it down in the comment section, and also follow Ultralytics here on YouTube. So I hope you have learned a ton in this video here and that you can use this in your own projects and applications, maybe getting some inspiration. And then I'll just see you in the next video. Until then, happy learning.